In this lesson, we will see how to use the debugger and really see the web request in action. So let me first set up here a couple of breakpoints, and I want to add a breakpoint here in the preparation before we fetch the context from the database, and I want to add another breakpoint here when I start rendering my page. So here in the page. And let's start the debugger here, and let's open our application in the browser. Okay, so the first stop point is here in the start of our preparation. Let me just step over, and now we are going to fetch the context from the database. Let me step over again, and here we have the contacts were fetched from the database. And if we expand this here, you'll see that we have the list property that is bound to the table records on the screen. You will also notice that, let me just double click here, this list property is filled in with the contacts that came from the database. So they are all here, and these are going to be rendered one by one on the screen. Now, this list here, this is a list of elements that is iterated during the server-side render stage, which is where we have our next breakpoint. So let me just close here this and let me continue. And you will notice that here on the debugger tab, we also have the widgets tab, which shows us the table record. And if you notice, the table record also has a list property. This list property is filled in when we bind the data from the aggregate into this table record. If you'll notice, if I double click here, you'll notice that the list is empty for now because I haven't started to render the table record. Once we start rendering the table records, let me just expand here and step over, you'll notice that the list was populated with the contacts that came from the database. Now, another important property here inside this list property is the current element. This property of the list indicates what is the current element when the list is being iterated. In this case, let me just go back here into the in-use, you'll notice that the current is pointing to Joanna Rivera. So this is the contact that is being rendered in this step. If we continue, this is going to render Joanna's phone number. If we continue, we will move on to the next contact, which is Dwayne. So if we go back here into the list, let me just double click here, you'll see that the first contact was Joanna, the second is Dwayne, and so on and so on. So let me just continue here the request, and we will see that the request ended. Let me just go back to the browser, and here we have our list of contacts with Joanna, Dwayne, and so on. And that's it.